Welcome to the YouTube channel of Michael J. Swanson. Michael is the author of How David Beats Goliath and is the CEO of Advocate Capital. And now, here's Michael.
Doctor, thanks for being with us again. We appreciate you.
All right. It's good to be here.
Yeah, absolutely. So you were recently telling me about a case that you've had that involved, I think it's a home developer and racism. Can you share the story of that with us?
Sure. I mean, you would think that these days are long in the past, but they're not. In this case, it's probably 10 years ago. I mean, but that being said, you still see what was transpiring back then today. But you had a major, major urban developer. And when I say developer, they built homes and communities and the like.
Okay.
And we had, thank God, we had a whistleblower in this case. We had a woman who was in the higher administration of this corporation who tape recorded the vice president of sales and the vice president of operations,
wow,
essentially instructing the entire staff that for certain communities, they did not want any black people over there selling houses. So essentially what they were doing, they were like, okay, this particular community is going to be white. And to the extent that it's going to be white, we want the representatives from our company who's selling them the property to be white.
Wow.
And so they steered the black real estate agents to other communities where I guess this company said it's acceptable to have black people there. I mean, you talk about staunch, stark racism at its best. And that was going on. And it there was no color coding to it. It was very direct. It was very linear. And it happened. We wound up settling this case for an undisclosed amount of money. But we had about 12 clients. But there were a number of agents and people who were affected.
Yeah.
And I do believe that by virtue of us shining a light on this practice, which we believe was something that was happening regularly with other developers also.
Yeah.
It stopped a trend in the metro Atlanta area. And just know this. I mean, we live in America. The idea that you could have systemic racism like this, where you have owners of property telling their employees, don't sell it to black people, or we only want white people to buy it. That's appalling. It is appalling, but it happened. And I'm so proud of the result that we got from our firm for these clients. These clients still call me today. They're happy. And I'll be candid with you. I don't see this company or many others doing the same thing, obviously. I just don't see it. I mean, not overtly.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think that, I don't know, some agency of the government is going to police that kind of thing or oversee that kind of thing. But what I've learned from having friends like you is that oftentimes it takes a civil action that has an economic penalty to get the attention and get them to actually change.
It's a combination of everything. I mean, I think that obviously having federal legislation and statutes and laws on board that clearly delineate to these builders that you can't do it helps. You know, a certain percentage of people just won't test the waters. But for those who see the federal laws and do it anyway, then ergo we come and we swing the hammer on them and swat them down. And it hurts a lot more than with the federal fines, because the fines were really the civil penalties that we get are much larger and they hit them directly in the pocket. So I think it's a combination approach that keeps these egregious systemic racist actions in check.
Beautiful. Well, thank you so much for the work that you do there in Atlanta and throughout the country to battle injustice and to make the world, frankly, a better and more just place. Thank you. We appreciate you.
Thank you. And again, I'm proud of our result.
Thanks for watching. Send your questions or comments to Michael at mike@howdavidbeatsgoliath.com.